Okay, our next speaker is Senator Singh.
Just about everyone on the affirmation believes that the government should scale down on its involvement in the mortgage market. However, we believe that the government should still have some foothold in this market because it will benefit the upper, middle, and lower class. I would like to agree with Senator Irakam, but I would like to add on that we can actually help the upper class, because if we are giving more loans to people, then we are boosting the economy. And the upper class contains the people who own the companies that supply appliances to these houses, for example, lumber and tiles. And when these people buy these houses, they'll need to buy these appliances, and the upper class is the contains the people who own these companies. In addition, an increase in households that buying more homes will benefit the United States as a whole. For example, this will help families climb up the economic ladder. Did you know that home ownership increases safety among neighborhoods? It increases the education in public school systems, creates safer streets, and promotes small business growth? And by having the government have a foothold in the mortgage market, we are also increasing the number of rentals that will occur. Not to mention, rentals are great, and they help boost the economy too. And they're a great place for starting households. They create affordable shelter for many Americans, and they create a safe place to live. Overall, the housing market accounts for over 20% of the United States economy. Therefore, the United States should have a very strong and very strong appeal and strong importance in this market. First and foremost, the guarantee that these banks will not do because the United States government backs them helps lessen the intensity of the boom and burst cycles. For example, in the 1930s, when Fannie Mae was created, the government support started. Before that, every 5 or 10 years, the economy had boom or burst cycles where the economy would plunge into a recession. However, after that, there haven't been many great recessions. And in the 1980s, we saw a shift as the government insured deposits with a new system called government-backed mortgage securities. In fact, there hasn't that big of a mortgage crisis. There's only been one. And that's because Wall Street developed an alternative to Fannie Mae, which the exact wording is government-backed mortgage securities, which grew dramatically, supplanting Fannie and Freddie Mac as the largest source of mortgage finances in the United States. In other words, it is only when the government stops interfering with the mortgage market that the economy plunges. One obvious reason for the correlation between financial prosperity and government guarantee in the mortgage market is because the government stops run on banks, which is when people lose hope and lose confidence in banks. People will stop losing confidence in banks because people know that the government has a foothold in the market. By providing explicitly priced, limited government support for the system, we can provide credit for a broad range of people, which will boost the economy and lower foreclosures. By cutting off all government support, as my other senators have said, this will result in a system in which credit will be depleted, and people, especially of color and low moderate income households, will suffer because they will have a harder time getting homes, because according to my research, the price for getting a loan will increase. Specifically, the government backstop to the market will enable the 30-year fixed mortgage, which most people have when they begin their home buying process. It will lower that, and that will allow more people to enter the market, which will increase the government's function. And another reason that government support encourages the origination of loans is because of lower rates and favorable terms. Research has shown when the government is involved, the average loan rate and the terms are more generous compared to when there is a more strong foothold by the private sector. And these fairer terms allow, in addition, more people to buy homes, which will boost the economy further. A limited government will also support affordable renting. In my view, having the federal government have a role in the government and have a backstop will reduce the government's footprint in the market while still offering a broad and consistent access to safe, public, and a wide variety of options to choose from. Now, I'd like to contrast Senator Visionary's points by he's saying that, the United States government wasted $200 billion bailing out these companies. However, in a recent article, Fannie Mae has said they will give out $114 billion in dividends to taxpayers in just the past year. This shows the United States government is already coping with the loss and is actually starting to make money. This shows that the United States government, what it did was right in the time of great crisis. Also, Senator Suthi said, we should not take on more debt. However, as we all know, in order to bring prosperity to the nation, we need to take on more debt. We might need to raise the debt ceiling, but as we all know in our lives, needing to take on debt is an important part in the process by which you create money. This is called investment. Someone usually takes on debt, gets an investment, makes money, and pays back the debt, but at the long run, and last comes to last, they still made money. Thank you, and please vote in affirmation of the government having a strong foothold in the mortgage market. Thank you.
Questions? Senator Majibur? You said that the government needs to take on debt, and taking on debt is technically a good thing. Well, isn't debt really what causes many of the mortgage crises? And people not being able to pay back money cause a mortgage crisis, cause them to have their homes foreclosed. Didn't taking on debt even cause the Lehman Brothers to collapse and banks to collapse? How could you say raising the debt is a good thing? A necessary thing, that is.
Because raising the debt allows us to use that money to support these organizations and build money and make more money, and then we can pay back that debt. If we cut expenditure, then we're not fostering our economy, and then we're not going to make any money. That way, we're not going to lower our debt anyway. But if we take on more debt, sure, we'll have to pay back more debt, but we'll have money to pay back the debt with, compared to if we cut expenditure, then we won't make any money.
Senator Levin? We're currently in a $16 trillion debt, and you're saying that we should keep increasing that debt, so at one point we will be able to pay back. But when do you think that is?
Obviously, it's not in the near future that we'll be able to pay back this debt. But the point is that if we stop increasing the debt ceiling, then we will be left in a situation where the United States government will not be able to create more profit, because it is not to a great extent, but to some extent, we need some debt to create more profit, and then we can pay back the debt.
Senator Suthi?
Okay, first thing, according to inquiry, Chair, did you know that this speech lasted almost 8 minutes? And the second part, just another question. Senator, you said that there wouldn't be many bad crises over the years if this government support was continued over the past 80 so years. But if we look to just a couple of years ago, we had a very big recession that went on in the United States, and it almost crippled our economy. Please explain how, if we continue government support, that we can prevent these recessions and these really bad economic situations, when almost one of them, just a couple years ago, almost crippled our entire economy.
Okay, both Senator Singh and Senator Sethi, please respect time. It was supposed to be a 3-minute speech, and Senator Sethi, it was supposed to be a 20-second question. Okay, go ahead.
The recession was caused by non-guaranteed finance mortgages, mostly. So this shows that it wasn't the government's fault.
Okay, Senator Ravindran.
Senator, at the beginning of your speech, you said that this will help upper class, lower class, and middle class. It will help all United States citizens. I understand how it will help the upper class and lower class, but how does it help the middle class?
Because the middle class also needs to buy houses.
Well, yes, but it's not, they have the money, so why would they need to take a loan?
So they can buy a bigger house and they can...
They can go to South Jersey and buy a bigger house. And I think... Okay, Mihir, question, quick. Senator Singh has taken so long. Mihir, question.
Senator Singh, if the housing market needs external government support, doesn't that mean it is not self-sustaining? Why should we help a broken business model?
You have beautiful hair.
There, you know, there's a saying, well, I might get this wrong, don't throw out the baby with the bathwater. That means that, for example, if something's broken or something's not that great, you throw everything out, you try to fix it, you try to fix the problem, not just throw everything out and just give up hope.
Okay, thank you. And please keep your speeches short. I know you went off track. You can come in.